Well, we received word that a helicopter had gone down in Lake Eyre. The ABC had a helicopter there. And then we couldn't contact the helicopter, and it was been a long night of working with the police and waiting for official news. But we now understand that the helicopter has crashed. It's a terrible scene there. The police are telling us to expect no survivors, and we're waiting for official word to come through. We had three of our finest reporters, members of our news teams on that helicopter. All three of them had more than 20 years experience with us at the ABC. Paul Lockyer was a journalist with 40 years experience. And so this is a devastating loss to the ABC family and a devastating loss for Australian journalism. These were three of our finest who seem to have been lost overnight.
And they've all had a lot of experience in a wide variety of your shows, haven't they? There'll be a lot of memories flowing through this building today.
Absolutely. I mean, Paul Lockyer has been a journalist for more than 40 years, a distinguished foreign correspondent. He won a Logie for his coverage at the Sydney Olympics, and then in recent years has really focused on regional and rural Australia. He was the first reporter into Grantham earlier this year and was there for 24 hours reporting on the flood damage, the only journalist who could get into the town. So a remarkable journalist, an experienced mentor to many here and much loved. John Bean, one of our finest cameramen, a master craftsman behind the lens, and he was the cameraman that all our journalists wanted to work with. And Gary Tysis, he's run our helicopters here for decades, an important part of the team, getting our journalist to the story, covering natural disasters. He'd done some very distinguished work during the Sydney to Hobart race during some of the crises there over previous decades. So all three of them are widely known, much loved, greatly respected. And there's a great sadness here today. This will be one of our saddest days. And I think we're all in shock and in disbelief for that this is the news we're facing this morning.
And what happens from now? What have the police told you?
Well, we're waiting for official confirmation from the police, and then their investigations need to take place as to what happened, and we're in their hands on that as far as the substance and the timing, and so we're waiting to be guided by them.
And are you able to tell us a little bit more about what these men were actually shooting, what they were doing when they were involved?
Yeah, they had been in Lake Eyre previously, and they'd done two primetime documentaries for the ABC about how the outback was springing back to life with all the water from the rains and the floods. It's a once-in-a-generation experience out there, and they were out there shooting more stories about regional and rural Australia and the impact of the massive inland water. And that was going to be used for our news and current affairs programs and probably another documentary as well.
Okay.
Exceptional men and much loved.
Pardon?
Exceptional men.
Yeah, they were fine, fine men. Paul Lockyer, a mentor to many. They were team players, gracious, humble, much loved. And I think that's one of the things that's really stirred people up today. So many people in this organisation knew them, admired them, liked them, had worked with them, and it's a great shock.
Can I just clarify, two of the men were based in Sydney, were they in one?
Yeah, two were based in Sydney. Gary and Paul were based in Sydney. John was based in Brisbane. But both Paul and John had worked all over. Paul had been a foreign correspondent three times. John worked in Washington last year, and so widely known all around the ABC, these guys.
And you've been in touch with their families, I would
imagine? Yeah, I was in touch with their families through the night as we waited for news. Family and friends came around them. And I think they're still waiting for official news today, as we all are, official notification. But they understood the terrible reality of the circumstances as we understood them last night. And so it was the longest of nights, and it's now the saddest of days.
It must be very hard for a news-based organisation to be dealing with news like this.
It is. I've done a number of interviews this morning with people who knew these guys, had worked with these guys, and I think our journalists are dealing with this with great professionalism, great integrity, trying to get the story off as best they can. But yes, there's emotion in covering this story today. We're all terribly, terribly sad.
And how do you help the staff here?
We're going to have counsellors and counselling support in. We have an employee assistance scheme. We've invested quite significantly in helping journalists deal with traumatic circumstances. And so we have a system and a routine that we'll be putting into place, and we'll also be providing great support for the the family of these staff members as well.